I'm on a quest to make my own tools from scratch. And after learning some Stone Age skills, it's on to the Iron Age. The Stone Age ended with the discovery of metalworking in a period between 6000 and 2000 BC. The first use of iron as a tool was likely made from fallen meteors, which is one of the few natural sources of pure iron. Over time, humans learned how to extract iron from terrestrial sources in iron ore through a process called iron smelting. Before the Industrial Revolution, bog iron was a common source of iron, where iron minerals and water oxidize and can be extracted from the bottom of bogs. Most iron nowadays, however, is often mined from deep iron ore deposits in the earth. I'm at the Sudan Mine, one of the deepest iron mines in Minnesota. At nearly a half a mile deep, it truly shows the extent we go through to reach iron ore.
So back in the 1860s, there was a gold rush here in Minnesota, and they found some gold in this general area, but the big thing for Minnesota that they really found was the iron ore. And it took almost 20 years from when they actually found it to them actually opening up the iron mine itself.
Here we go.
We are half a mile under the earth right now, one of the deepest points of Minnesota.
The mine opened in 1882. Everything started open pit within 10 years, though they were fully underground and stayed in underground operation for the rest of the life of the mine, which closed in 1962. So had approximately 80 years of life. And during that time frame, they removed about 15.5 million ton of ore. All of this, for the most part, is the iron ore right here. And what we'll do is we're going to take the spiral staircase, we're going to head up into what was called the stope. It's a Cornish term, it means step up. So the miners stepped up into the ore. If you look right up there, you see that gray rock kind of sparkles. That is the iron ore. Here is a sample, and I'll let you feel both of them before you determine which is the iron ore and which is the waste rock. So approximately the same size, the one might be a little bit bigger, but you got the sparkly aspect to it as well. Mm-hmm. So by looks you can tell too, but so this is the hematite here that they would have mined. The other one is the Ely greenstone, that waste rock.
Now they had some iron ore, we headed back to the surface.
It is gonna be bright once we breach the surface just because you've been underground for a while. Hey, watch your step as you're coming out.
So we just got a tour of the mines. Now they're back on the surface. Can you tell us a little bit more about the mining process?
All they had to do to process this ore is drill and blast it underground, bring it to the surface, and then they would send it to our crusher house over here. And in there, they would crush it into 7-inch chunks, and then they could just load it onto the train cars and send it to two harbors.
Thanks, James. Next up, we're going to a blacksmith to learn how to work with this iron.